Hallo allemaal, welkom bij Dutch & Go. In a previous video I talked about how to improve your listening skills and the differences between active and passive listening. Today I'll be speaking about how to improve your speaking skills. And make sure to keep watching until the end where I'll be revealing a tip of what you definitely should not do when practicing speaking at home. Let's go! So, in previous videos of Spreektaal, I talked spontaneously about a certain topic, such as what languages I speak, what do I do in my spare time, and my opinion on the latest Taylor Swift album. For real, it was a good one. Really. Nice. But yeah, and then I got a lot of follow-up questions from students, how they could practice speaking at home themselves. So that's why I decided to make this video and give you some very basic tips and certain procedures. So first of all, we will define three elementary phases when practicing speaking at home. The first one is think about a topic. Think about a certain question or a theme that you want to discuss. Could also be a video or an article, okay? Think about something simple. If you've never done this, practicing speaking at home, think about something simple such as, wat zijn jouw plannen voor het weekend? Wat zijn jouw plannen voor vanavond? Hoe is jouw routine? Hoe is het weer? Something easy, okay? Then, let's go to the second phase. The second phase is the brainstorm phase, in which you can make lists of relevant words, verbs, vocabulary, relevant to the topic that you've chosen. In this phase, you can use a dictionary, and if you don't know how to use a dictionary, check out my previous video, in which I explained to you some different aspects of how to use a dictionary correctly, and don't use Google Translate. Yeah, don't use Google Translate. So first of all, let's think about a topic like wat zijn jouw plannen voor het weekend? And then think about all of the different activities that you'll be doing. So if we make a list, could be for example, met de kinderen spelen, and write it down exactly like this, met de kinderen spelen, naar televisie kijken, met vrienden dineren, op zondagmorgen lang slapen, thuis ontbijten, naar een klassiek concert gaan, op zondagavond thuis blijven en mijn kinderen met het huiswerk helpen. Okay? So there you go. These are some very simple actions or activities that maybe you'll be doing over the weekend, or maybe not. I don't know. But yeah, you can adjust these, of course, according to your actual plans. So now the third phase is speak freely. Okay, this is a little bit awkward maybe, and people might think that you're crazy, but yeah, well, you're speaking Dutch, so yeah, you're always a little bit crazy, I guess. But anyway, practice speaking at home, and use these words that you've written down so nicely before as a speaking guide, okay? It will be complicated, a little bit awkward in the beginning, but hey, that's part of the deal. Don't forget to use linking words such as time words, op zondagavond, op zondagmorgen, or dan, then, daarna, after that, or tenslotte, finally. And then you could end up with a short presentation on your plans for the weekend that sounds like this. Op zaterdagmorgen ga ik met mijn kinderen spelen. Smiddags ga ik naar televisie kijken. En 's avonds ga ik met vrienden in de stad dineren. Op zondagmorgen wil ik lang slapen. En daarna ga ik thuis ontbijten. Op zondagmiddag zal ik naar een klassiek concert gaan. En op zondagavond wil ik gewoon thuis blijven. En ik moet mijn kinderen met het huiswerk helpen. En dat zijn mijn plannen voor het weekend. So there you go. This was, I'm sure, for A1 students, for even A11 students, a very achievable presentation on what your plans for the weekend are. Basically, the more often you do it, the more often you'll start to feel comfortable, and you'll also start to discover your own voice in Dutch. You'll start to discover a natural speaking pace, a pace that feels good for you, what words you prefer, what expressions you prefer, when you should use inversion, when not, etc. All of these things can help you to just develop a sort of natural sounding voice when speaking Dutch. An important tip as well here is to record yourself. That way you can hear mistakes. Okay? At the beginning you won't hear maybe a lot of mistakes, but the more you do it, the more often you'll start to notice, oh, okay, I didn't actually apply inversion here where I should have. This structure is not correct, etc. You'll start to recognize mistakes. That is super important. And you can use this method that I've just presented to you here, so a method where you brainstorm about a specific topic and then speak freely in different contexts. So think about things like presenting YouTube video, making a presentation about a topic, summarizing an article into your own words, or discussing a video of Netbox, which is a fantastic Flemish website where you find short videos in Flemish for students that you can use to speak about, to listen to, etc. So all of these things together make for quite a complete exercise as a whole. But always remember to just write down important words, a phase in which you can use the dictionary as well, and then only after that start to speak freely. Students who are at the end of A1 could also, for example, integrate this quite easily into their daily life by starting their day describing shortly what their plans are for that day and ending the day describing what they've just done that day, okay? And that way you just practice the different tenses and you can come back to the same activities twice. If you can describe that, and if you can do that without a problem, then move on to other topics, okay? But like that, I think, is a very productive way to practice speaking at home. You could also stand in front of a mirror and look at yourself speaking. I mean, I know, awkward, but hey, no one said that it shouldn't be. And it really helps to become more self-aware and, yeah, to just become aware of what you look like when you're speaking Dutch and to, of course, look at your mouth and lips movement when you're speaking as well. So that might be helpful. And finally, you don't always have to be home to practice speaking. You don't always have to use a dictionary before or brainstorm about vocabulary before when speaking, because sometimes it's just not possible or you don't have time. And then you can also just be in the real world outside and just zoom out and think about what it is that you're doing. I'm standing in front of a bus stop. Ik sta bij een bushalte. Or I'm taking the bus. Ik neem de bus. I'm working on the computer. Ik werk op de computer, etc. So just in your head, think about what it is that you're doing and whether you're able to actually say that in Dutch, and that will also help you a lot. And as a final tip, something that you should never, ever, ever do, which is don't ever write a text and then read that text out loud if you want to practice speaking. If you write down a text and you read it out loud, you'll have practiced writing a text and, yeah, reading it out loud. You won't have that same level of independency with the tips that I've just given you, okay? Reading a written text out loud is not productive when it comes to speaking at all, okay? So just remember that. Rather use these bricks, these individual words, to build your house rather than just, yeah, basically constructing, having a completely constructed house. And I'm not sure where I'm going with this metaphor. It doesn't matter. Just don't write out a text and then read it out loud. That's basically the message. Thank you so much for watching. Leave a comment if you have any questions. Check out my blog where you find a more involved or a little bit more elaborate description of how to practice speaking at home. See you next time. Tot de volgende keer. Dag!